Paula is virtuous.
She definitely puts a spark in other people when she's around them.
She brings joy into the room. She lightens up everything with people, even if she doesn't know you. She's so warm and welcoming.
Well, why I moved to Florida is because I needed a change. After the death of my mom on Christmas morning, 1988, after I graduated in my senior year of high school, it was time that my husband and I decided to relocate to Florida.
When we visited Florida, I always saw from a young child, I loved Florida when I saw the warm weather, the people. You'd see the palm trees and it's warm at nighttime, you come out.
I was currently working in a department store in Hempstead, so I researched the store and I put in a transfer to come to Tampa.
We just had it in our mind to follow the Spirit of God, and by faith we would pick up and go.
And when I got here, the store had closed down. They went bankrupt. They never told me that when I left New York. My mom, still in my heart, told me that this was the place I needed to be. And my husband and I, we just decided to stay. We looked for some jobs. My husband found a job and we relocated. He's going down. He's going down. I met Nigel working in a department store called Abraham and Strauss. At that time, I was 17 years of age.
When I was in that process of getting ready to get engaged with her, I was supposed to meet her at a specific time. And I wasn't able to meet her at a specific time because I was trying to get my hair cut up and look good for her that evening. We had a miscommunication, and it was bad feelings, and it was supposed to be a real special time to get engaged to her. And then so when I actually came to her house, she was disappointed in the simple fact that she was like, you were standing me up, and she was upset. Then, you know, I had to just break down and show her. I said, well, it was supposed to be a special time, and, you know, the reason I was so late and why I took so much time into getting my hair cut and everything done was, and I showed her the ring, and then she just started crying, and then of course I started crying, and then we started crying.
We ended up interacting with each other and we became friends, and we both worked together, and that's how we met. We kind of met working together in the department store, and that was it.
That was a special moment.
Everybody thought they were so active, and they always active in the church.
I used to do the phone, and I used to do the, where's the brochures? We don't do the brochures.
Okay. No, we don't.
Being a mom, not having my mom to help assist, walk me through as a mom, it was interesting. And so having two sons and three daughters, and then eventually gaining an extra son, my adopted son, which his name is Ryan.
Even though I'm the middle child of five kids, and most people would say you have middle child syndrome, I don't feel like I had that. I feel like my mom knew me as an individual as much as she knew me as just her children as a whole. Sometimes you hear about, like, you know, you don't have a lot of time with your parents, but I don't feel like that ever was my story with my mom. I feel like we always had time to get to know her and for her to really get to know us. As having my first son, first child, I feel like my mom always put our needs above her own. So I feel like that's something that I've carried into now, like having a husband and having a house and having a child. Like, I feel that my mom, I've learned that sometimes you have to put others before you and rely on other people to take care of you as much as you take care of them.
I just feel, for me, I think I made the right decision being a mom to my children. And I think as they're older now, they tell me that more and more each day.
Going to see my father, Paul, who's in the nursing home. He's gonna probably be pretty sad because I usually bring him something. So this is Cure with Care.
Now I take care of my father as well in Florida. After my mom passed away, he wanted to move to Florida, so I feel like I'm a mother to him.
Hello. nurse?
Just,
no, I'm just standing. Oh, do you see my dad? Yeah.
My dad and my mom had a lot of discrepancies, why my mom ended up becoming a single mom. And so by the age of 12, I think at that time, I was beginning to, you know, when you're a teenager, you start learning who you are and you want to know who's your dad and why I haven't seen my dad and what's going on with my dad. I looked my dad up and I found him through his sister in New York, and we all reunited and we met our dad. And from that day forth, me and my dad has always had this relationship. I've come to find out I'm named after my dad.
Malia, new baby name gonna be Malia, Daddy Paul.
Malia.
He says I'm his favorite, but he would say that I would draw and do little things, and he would love when I would come and visit him. And to find out my dad was diagnosed with mental illness, post-traumatic stress disorder, after coming out of the military, I knew that that was the reason for why my mom became a single mom. It wasn't by choice, but it was something that she needed to do. And when I met my dad, I felt that he had such a great heart and he loved all of his children. And for me, I said if I could do anything as a child of God, a child that's living, is I would make the last days the best days of my dad's life.
Paula, you are the love of my life. I love the God in you. I love your passion.
Thank you for all the sacrifices that you've done, given to us.
I appreciate you bringing me closer into the family, supporting our relationship, and everything that you've done with baby boy, having his yaya.
Yaya.
Yeah, I could say we love you and everything that you've done for us.
And baby boy says he loves you too, Yaya.
Love you, love you, love you.
I said, oh, you know, would you like to come and move to Florida? And he said, yeah, you're right. And so he said, I wouldn't mind moving to Florida. So I said, well, if I come get you, would you come? And he said,
I'm coming.
I sure will.
I was born by the river in a little tent.
He lived with me for a few months and he took ill in the VA hospital. I could no longer take care of him here in the home. And so he ended up in a facility and has been in a facility since, but it doesn't stop me from being there, feeding him, singing, dancing, celebrating his birthday.
Oh, yes, he will.
I can ever be. Knocking me. When I talk about him and my mom, it just touched deep because I know that they are the two that gave us life and gave me life to be here.
Oh, yes, he will.